Hello friends, in this video I will show you how to create an activity with two different fragments which will be displayed on button click. So here I will create a new project. In this project I will create an empty activity and I will name this project as fragments. The package name is set. I will set the language to Java and I have selected the minimum SDK version to 21. Then I click on finish. So after this it will create the main activity and then it will sync the Gradle. So you can see Gradle sync project is in progress. So once the Gradle sync is finished, we can proceed. So now the new activity which this has created, you can see that for this activity the theme is theme.fragments and this we can find in the resource folder. In resource folder, in values you can find this themes folder, and inside this there is this themes.xml and this contains this theme.fragments, and this theme is theme.materialcomponents.daynight.darkActionBar. So this contains an action bar which is dark, and then it contains this color primary and all these colors which you can see, these are blue and green and so on. But when you are in Sketchware, you can find that the style is actually no action bar. In styles.xml you can see that the app theme is theme.appcompat.light.noActionBar. So that's why in Sketchware they add a coordinator layout, then app bar layout and toolbar. But here we do have an action bar, so we do not need toolbar here. Now let's proceed to main.xml. In activity main.xml they have a constraint layout with a text view, but here I need two buttons and a frame layout. In frame layout I will display the fragments, and the fragments will be displayed on button click. That's why I need two buttons. So here I will go to this design and click on layouts, and I will add a frame layout. Okay, now I will add buttons. This is button 1 and another button, button 2. Now we have to set the constraints. So this is the left constraint for button 1. This will be the right constraint for button 1. This will be the top constraint. Okay, and this will be the bottom constraint. Now for the button 2. This is the bottom constraint, the right, and the left constraint, then the top constraint and the bottom constraint. Okay, let's have a look at the code. We do not need this text view, so I'll just remove this text view from here. Then we have frame layout for which I have not set the constraint. So for frame layout I will set the top constraint to bottom of button 1 and bottom constraint will be at the bottom of main activity. This is the right constraint and this is the left constraint. Now let's have a look at the code. Okay, it is to bottom of parent, to end of parent and to start of parent to bottom of ID button. Now for ID button, it is to start of constraint, end is to start of button 2. Okay, constraint start is to start of parent, and this we have to make it 0 dp. I'll just make it 0 dp here. So now we have this frame layout button 1 and button 2. For button 2, the constraint to end of parent and constraint top is okay, we have to make some changes here for button 2. Constraint start constraint start to start of parent. Okay, now it has come on opposite side. So I'll just change it. Constraint start will be to end of, and I will change it to at ID. Button. Now this looks fine. We have this button 1, button 2 and this fragment. For the fragment, the width will be match parent and height will be 0 dp. Okay, now we have this one error. This view is constrained vertically. At runtime, it will jump to the top unless you add a vertical constraint. Okay, we need a vertical constraint for this. So I will add constraint top. We need a constraint top here. So I'll just copy this and paste it here. The constraint top of both the buttons will be to top of parent. Now it looks fine. We have this frame layout and the two buttons. The text of the buttons we have to change. So here I will make it button 2. And this will be button 1. So main.activity main.xml is done. Now in Android, for frame layout, I have to add an ID. So here I will add Android ID frame 1. Okay, now let's create the fragments. For this, I will click on layout here in resource folder. Click on activity main.xml and click on new layout resource file. Here I will create fragment1.xml, fragment 1, and click OK. It will automatically create this fragment1.xml. Inside this, I will add a button and I will add a text view. Okay, for this button, this will be the top constraint. This is the bottom constraint, the left constraint, the right constraint, and the left constraint. So it is in center now. Next, for this text view, this is the text view. For this, I will set the left constraint and then the right constraint. This is the bottom constraint and the top constraint. Okay, it is still at the bottom, so I'll set the top constraint for this. Yeah, this seems fine. So now I have this button and text view. The ID of this text view will be text view 1, and for button, okay, let it be text view. For button, the ID is button 3. Now I'll just copy this code and I will create a new fragment, new layout resource file, fragment2.xml. In this, I will go to code and I will paste the code which I have copied. So in fragment 2, I will change the IDs for button. First button, I will change, set the ID to button 4. And for text view, I will set the ID to text view 4. Here also, I will set it to text view 4. So this is done now. I have fragment 1 and fragment 2. Now I will create the activity for these two fragments. So here I will go to Java file. In Java, I will click on this main activity. Then I will click on new Java class. And here I will write first fragment. So this will be the Java file first fragment. Here I will write extends fragment. Here we have to select this androidx.fragment.app. So now we have a fragment class. Inside this we need onCreateView event. So here I will add this public view onCreateView. Okay, and we have to remove all these non-null parameters. Okay, we have to remove the nullable because we do not have JetBrains library here, so I will remove all these things. Now next, I will inflate the view. So here we already have a layout inflator. So here I will create a view. View. Frag view is equal to inflator dot inflate r dot layout dot fragment 1. Comma, we have to add the container. Here we have this view group container which I have added here. Comma, attached to root false. So here I will add this false, and then I will return this frag view. Okay, so on create view is done. Now we have to inflate, we have to get the button and text view. That I will do in on view created event. On view created event. So here also we have to remove this. Nullable code jetbrains.annotations.nullable. Now after this we have to declare the buttons. So button button 3 is equal to, we can use this view here. So I will add this view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot button 3 in fragment 1.xml. You can see that we have button 3 and text view. So next I'll go to this first fragment dot java and add this text view. Text view text view 3 is equal to view dot find view by ID r dot ID dot the text view, this one. Next I will set an on click listener for this button. 3 dot set on click listener, new view dot on click listener. So in this on click listener for the button I will set the text of text view. Text view 3 dot set text here I will set the text as this is fragment 1. Okay, so that's all in fragment 1 or the first fragment. Now in fragment 1 I will change the text size of this text view. It is looking very small, so I will change the text size to 24 dp. okay, and same in fragment 2 also. Text size 24 dp. Now let's go to first fragment dot java. Here I will copy this. Now again I will go to this project, click on this first fragment or main activity and then right click new java class. Here I will create second fragment. Second fragment. In this I will paste the same thing. Now in second fragment there are some changes. We have to change the name of this class as second fragment and it will extend fragment. Now here the view which we inflate is fragment 2, and in on view created we have will have button 4 which will be r.id.button4 and we'll have text view 4 and this will be text view 4. Next we have on click listener for button 4, and when this is clicked in text view 4 we just set, we set the text as this is fragment 2. Okay, so in fragment 2 you can see that the ID is button 4 here and for text view it is text view 4. So second fragment is done and first fragment is done. Now we go to main activity.java. Here we have to get the buttons. So first I will have button 1 is equal to find view by id r dot id dot button, this one. So this is the first button. Now I copy this and paste it again, and next I define the button 2. This will be r.id.button2. Okay, and then I have to set an onClick listener for button 1. In this onClick listener for button 1, first I define the fragment transaction. Android X, you have to always select Android X whenever you find two such things. So fragment transaction is equal to get fragment manager, get support fragment manager dot begin transaction. In next line we have to define the fragment. So first I will define this first fragment. Here I will write first fragment 1, I will name it as fragment 1 is equal to new first fragment. Okay, next we have to write transaction dot replace r dot id dot, here we have to write the id of the frame layout. So that is frame 1 comma, we have to replace it with fragment 1. So and after this we have to commit transaction dot commit. So when button 1 is clicked it will display fragment 1. Similarly we have to do the same thing for button 2. So when button 2 is clicked we have to define second fragment. Second fragment, fragment 2 is equal to new second fragment, and we replace the frame 1 with fragment 2 and then we commit the transaction. And that's all. Now let's check this. So now the app has compiled and you can see that it contains an action bar at the top, then it contains this button 1 and button 2. When I click on button 1, it displays the fragment 1 which contains a button and text view. When I click on this button, it displays this is fragment 1. When I click on button 2, it will display the second fragment. And when I click on this button in second fragment, in text view, it displays this is fragment 2. So in this way, I can display different fragments in one activity or one page. So that's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this.